Hi everyone, welcome to this very short video that I've shot at Mungkong Gadget in Bangkok, Thailand. So I've come to Bangkok to visit, and Mungkong is a pretty famous audiophile store, and I've messed up Mungkong's headphone collection today because I've been listening to a whole variety of headphones. You see some Grados here, some Odysseys, some Hyphemen, some Stax way up on top, and of course they have some Odysseys here, some Stax, LCD5. There's a bunch of stuff they have here. And of course, you know, IEMs, DAPs. So their IEM collection is here. And I've been listening to a lot of the ESTATs, especially the Shangri-La Junior, the SR009, the 009S, the Odyssey Carbon. I've had a great time. And of course, I will be dropping a written review. And I've been very impressed with Wu Audio's amps, especially the Wu West. Amazing amp. I've listened to a bunch of ESTAT amps before, including the Kevin Gilmore KG-SSH-V Carbon. I've actually owned a Carbon, and I've owned the SR009, the 009S. But to my mind, this is by far the best electrostatic amplifier that I've heard. I've also heard, if you can see over there, the Wu Audio WA33, which I've heard before. And the WA33 was pretty amazing. This was Vara and the Odyssey LCD4, the LCD5, and a few others. However, I want to sort of leave you with some final thoughts on one of the best DACs, if not the best DAC I've ever heard. So, I mean, these two DACs honestly are the two best DACs that I've heard. I've had like jaw-dropping moments with both these DACs. I've listened to this DAC with the Wu Audio West, because I feel like if you have to evaluate DACs, of course, speakers are much better. But if you have to listen to headphones, I think ESTAT headphones are more revealing of source gear. So I've used ESTAT headphones to sort of assess. Firstly, on the bottom, well, as a matter of fact, I listened to the DAC on the top first. The DAC on the top is the DCS Rossini Apex DAC. So this is the new Rossini Apex DAC, and guys, it was mind-blowing. So when I listened to the Apex DAC from the DCS Rossini, guys, it was set to upsampling to DSD, and I mean, every audiophile superlative that you can think of that has been thrown around in audiophile jargon applies to this DAC. Honestly, like, it was detailed, it was layered, it was well separated, the staging was massive, it was natural. And even on an ESTAT like the Hyphemen Shangri-La Junior, and I've listened to a bunch of other ESTAT headphones on this, I mean, ESTATs are not supposed to do bass well, but off the Rossini, the new Rossini Apex DAC, the bass was phenomenal. The layering was phenomenal. And see, the other thing I want to say is that having tried MSV DACs, so some DACs are famous for having a macro focus and some DACs have a micro focus. So let's say, for example, if you heard the Core Dave to my mind had a very micro focus. So you could hear, let's say for instance, you could focus on the vocals. The Hall Audio May DAC, which is an R2R DAC, has a macro focus. So you sort of zoom out and you get the entire presentation. When I was listening to Rossini and then the Vivaldi, the impression I had is that these DACs have both a micro and a macro. And I have no idea how they do this. It's extremely lifelike. The staging, the placement of images is, guys, I mean, people talk about out of the head, people talk about precise imaging, but nothing comes close to this. The Rossini is just mind-blowing. I was not able to review this when I was listening to this. I was just transfixed. And then came the Vivaldi, and I just wasn't able to get out of my stupor, to get out of this sort of haze that I was in. I was just blown away. The Rossini is, of course, expensive. It comes in at around $36,000. The Vivaldi is even more expensive. But guys, I mean, if there's something worth saving for, it's these DACs. Because the amount of difference it can make to your listening pleasure is just not something I can describe in words. Like, take every audiophile superlative you've ever heard, and all of them are applicable to these DACs. One of the differences I want to point out between the Rossini and the Vivaldi is that the Vivaldi is, of course, a higher end DAC and more refined, more detailed, very impressive. But the Vivaldi is, of course, slightly more laid back, and the Rossini is slightly more upfront. So they do have different flavors. So I could honestly see someone wanting to own both of them. So anyway, I just want to give a big thank you to the guys at Mungkong Gadget for setting this up. And you know, Mungkong is supplied by Deco 2000 in Bangkok. So big shout out to those guys. Very friendly, very, very affable, very cooperative. And I've had an amazing time listening to the DACs and the gears here. So that's it for me. I hope this was useful, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye.